One morning in the park, Luke, Rhesus, Cleo, Luella, Dixon, Bluey, Bingo and I were playing tag with Doug. Doug was the chaser, and we loved running around and trying to escape from the not-so-flesh-hungry zombie. I was running like crazy, trying to get away from Doug, and hid behind a tombstone so he couldn't find me. Doug looked all around for a minute, then he saw a spike of my curly hair popping out from behind the tombstone. Doug crept up slowly and quietly towards the grave and yelled, "Boo, dude!" I screamed, not because he was scary, but because something was really wrong with him. His left eye had fallen out of his socket on purpose. "Someone help!" I cried. "Sorry, dudes. It seems that my eye had fallen out on purpose when I was playing tag with you," said Doug.
"Then where did you last leave it?" asked Bingo.
"In my socket, of course," said Doug. Then his face fell. "Only, I hadn't seen it since I last made Cleo it. Where's my eye? Where's my eye?"
"Calm down, Doug. We can, find your eye for you," said Luella.
"You said it, Luella. We all have to split up and search this very park for Doug's eye. On your marks!
Stop that noise!" cried Cleo.
"Why?" we all asked. "Because we need to say something other than go. What about eyeballs?"
"Eyeballs it is," said Dixon.
Luella gagged a little.
"On your marks, get set, eyeballs!"
Everyone raced around the park searching for Doug's eyeball. They searched by the swings and the slide and the seesaw and near the climbing frame, and they even asked their parents and somehow Zecora, but nobody seemed to find Doug's eye. I was just on the verge of giving up when Dig ran up to me. His nose sniffing in the air.
"Hello, boy," I smiled. "What do you smell?"
Dig closed one eye to indicate he has done the impossible. My friends came racing up to me. "What is it? What's Dig trying to say?" asked Rhesus.
"I think he says he knows where Doug's eyeball is. Come on, let's follow him," I said.
We ran after Dig along the park until Dig stopped at where he found Doug's eyeball. It was sitting on a swing. "My eye!" cried Doug.
"Hooray!" we all cried.
Then Doug noticed something. Chloe was about to have a turn on the swings. Quickly, Doug grabbed his eye and stuffed it back into its socket.
"Phew!" he sighed.
"Thank you for finding my eye, half doggy dude," said Doug. "Without you, I think I would have never found my eye."
"And you deserve bickies for this," I smiled,
and took a dog biscuit out of my pocket. Dig crunched away happily, knowing that even pets can be heroes if they help their masters with the most important and tricky tasks.